President Trump held his first face-to-face meeting yesterday with Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan as the two countries worked to mend relations. As we reported, topics included counterterrorism and trade. And after some public disagreements between the countries, the two leaders appeared to be in good spirits during their meeting. Joining us now is Farah Ispahani. She's a former member of the parliament in Pakistan. She's also a senior fellow at the Religious Freedom Institute and a global fellow at the Wilson Center. Farah, welcome back. What did you think about the president welcoming the prime minister to the Oval Office?
It was a little shocking for Pakistan watchers and unprecedented because President Trump has actually been very strong about Pakistan's role in supporting terrorism, in supporting terrorist groups that have attacked American servicemen, that have killed Americans in India in the Mumbai attacks. So he's also, you know, his administration has suspended aid, military and civilian, to Pakistan. So it was quite a surprise.
And because of all those reasons, because of the attacks, there's been strained relations between the U.S. and Pakistan on a number of all those issues. What do you make of the timing of this meeting? Why did this happen now?
Well, after Osama bin Laden was found in Pakistan, many, many people in the U.S. administration and people who have, are part of the establishment thought now America will move on from Pakistan's lies. But the U.S. is having an issue with its Afghan peace policy. They are failing with the Taliban, basically, because the Taliban have been just waiting for the U.S. to leave, and they want to form another Islamist Sharia state like they did before. And we remember, right, Wyatt? I mean, there's stonings of children, of killing women, the atrocity of that administration. So, you know, and they're refusing to talk to the Afghan government, which was democratically elected, and the U.S. oversaw those polls. So the bottom line is that it's floundering. The peace process is floundering, and the United States now feels maybe Pakistan, which has aided and abetted the Taliban all these years, maybe we really need to get them involved.
It was interesting because when you think about some of those issues, because Trump and Khan discussed working together to bring peace and stability to the region, but yet out of all that, they didn't mention, or I don't remember them mentioning, the issue of religious freedom, such a key issue. Why do you think that is so significant when you think about that region to ensure religious freedom?
Well, you know, this administration has done more for religious freedom, putting it on the map, Secretary Pompeo at the State Department, President Trump in the White House. We have never seen anything like it. And it has been so welcome for people of faith everywhere, for human rights activists everywhere. So coming on the heels of the State Department Ministerial on Religious Freedom, this was shocking. Mm-hmm. Pakistan has the worst blasphemy laws in the world. One Asia Bibi, the poor Catholic woman who was now taken out of Pakistan to safety, has left. But there are 200 other Asia Bibis being persecuted because of their faith. So it is impossible for a government like Pakistan, the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, which the constitution, the laws, everything works against religious freedom as we know it here in the United States. How can they make peace?
So important that we continue to highlight this, and I'm sure that the State Department will continue to work on this. I know you were had mentioned you were at the Ministerial to Advance Religious Freedom last week. Farah Ispahani, Global Fellow at the Wilson Center and Senior Fellow at the Religious Freedom Institute, thanks so much for coming in today.
Thank you, Wyatt.